This is flower for you, my future scholars. Hi, my friends. Hope you are doing great. I just got back today from a training for tomorrow competition, Dragon Boat Race in Hanoi, Vietnam. And I am one of the members in the UK Chimening alumni. And this is the uniform that we're going to use tomorrow, and there's a flower we got today to recognize us just we are going to attend the event. So the topic today actually talking about encouraging you to take it more carefully and take it more seriously in looking at different events, different activities, different things that you can do after you going abroad to study. So I already shared with you how to apply for a scholarship, how to write an essay, how to actually be like a standing out candidate by being yourself. And today is really to emphasize on what can you do after you finish studying, what would be your contribution to the alumni network. And I just give an example, my case, Chimening alumni network, to give you this kind of specific idea. Maybe you apply for Fulbright, or maybe you apply for Envada or Erasmus. But I believe that all these scholarships always had the question about what can you do for the relationship between the scholarship sponsor and your own country. Because it's kind of one of the return investment factor. They invest in you, they give you the support about finance and also network and emotional support. And now after you studying, what could be your contribution? What could be the return investment measured by your development and your contribution back to the relationship and to the development of your country? So I would like you to now go to Facebook or go to google.com, our father Google, where you can find most everything, and you just search for the alumni network of the scholarship that you want to apply. And I believe that maybe you already know that, so I would like you to take a look at all the activities, or at least three activities that they do every year, or maybe one time, 2 years. You really want to take a look at these activities, and then you can give specific example of what can you do after you finish studying in the country that you're going to study. But the idea is that you really want to take a bit time and effort to find out these activities, and then you can align your stories and your strengths and what can you do. For example, in my case, I never knew about this event before. It was not so active in the alumni network, I could argue, but then there was this event and other event that there's a lot to do with organizing and about sport, which somehow really align with what I like to do. So when I attend these things, I just, oh my God, the people, they're wonderful, because you may have the reverse culture shock after coming back from UK or US if you study abroad, and now you meet the people who somehow studied there before, so they kind of like had the similar, like they we call like like-minded people. So you probably feel the feeling of engaged again, and you feel like you are in the group that support you to develop. So basically, after this event, I think I got closer to the UK alumni than before, and I could tell myself that I need to take more time and effort to attend more activities, meaningful activities of the UK alumni. So I would like you to also join me to search for different events of the scholarship that you're going to apply, what they do after that for the alumni, and then make kind of like time for yourself and answer what would you do to contribute to that. And if you already finished studying, congratulations, and now you have any kind of feeling that nobody understand you, maybe the alumni network is a network for you to go to. So with that, have a wonderful day, my friend, and always be energetic and always love light as it's rose, beautiful, bring more beauty to life.